Before some days, some fellow metalheads, YouTubers, metalheads, started an editorial to speak about their 50 best black metal albums. For example, Bryce Talks Metal, he was the first, afterwards a Quest for Metal, he made his also video about his 50 best black metal albums, and here I come to speak also about my 50 best top black metal albums. And this is a not easy task at all, because first of all, it's very difficult. If you like black metal, it's very difficult even to speak about 50 albums. One thing. Secondly, here I prefer to speak about 50 different bands. So in the beginning I thought to speak about even more albums of the same band, but I say to myself, let's make a list of 50 different bands. Okay, so here also the place that I put the albums is not about my favorite or about it's very random, so it's not about which comes first, which comes second, about my favorite taste, not at all. I like everything here the same way, let's say. So let's start. Apsu from United States, one of the first bands from United States that started to play black metal. Of course, in the beginning they were even more death metal, afterwards they became something between black and thrash metal. And here we have, if I'm not sure, their third album, The Third Storm of Synthraul, something like that. For me, the best Apsu album of all time. Black thrash metal masterpiece. Burzum of Varg and his fourth album, Philosophem. For me, this is his best album of all time. Of course, I'm not speaking about his stupid ideas. Of course. Blasphemy from Canada. This band is one of the first also raw bestial black metal bands. And here we have their debut album, Fallen Angel of Doom, one of my favorites of all time. Mayhem, of course, from Norway, the leaders of the second wave of black metal, and their first debut album, The Mysteries Dom Satanas. One new band, one woman's band, from United States of America. The girl behind the band came to United States from Belgium, Hulder, and her first studio album, God's Slaughtering Hymns of a Forlorn Peasantry. For me, one of the best black metal albums of 2021. Taake, one Norwegian, also one man's band. Here we have his first debut album, Natested. Also, I don't like his pro-Nazi ideas, of course, but this album is very, very, very good. Another band with also their, let's say, Nazi sympathizers, Inquisition from United States of America. Originally they came from Colombia. I like everything of their albums, but here we will speak about their last album of 2020, Black Mass for a Mass Grave. Moon Sorrow from Finland. They play a style between folk, black metal and doom metal. Here I have their debut album, Sunden Uni. Another very beloved black metal band from Norway, Immortal, and here I could speak about all their first albums, but here I will speak about their fifth album, at the heart of winter. Another new one-man band from Denmark, Afsky. His second full studio album, Off the Jack Drummer Mink Dodd, I Dream About My Dad, something like that. This album was one of the best albums of 2020. Enslaved from Norway and their second album, Frost. Afterwards, they became even more progressive, but metal, progressive black, but here they were Viking black metal. One Israeli band, Melech S, they play a style between black thrash metal, Mesopotamian black thrash metal, they call their music, and their third album, if I'm not sure, Sphinx. Necrophobic from Sweden, they play something between melodic black and melodic death metal, something between them, and their masterpiece Dark Side. Balsakov from England, for me, one very underrated band with only unfortunately six studio albums, and their second album, Starfire Burning Upon the Ice Veiled Throne of Ultima Thule. Ulver from Norway, and their third album, Nathan's Madrigal. Also, afterwards, they stopped to be black metal and stopped to be even metal at all. But here we have a very, very special black metal album. Falkenbach from Germany, another one-man's band of epic black metal. And his album Heralding the Fireblade. He plays something between folk, epic, black metal. Drucht, if I prefer, well, their name, from Ukraine. Blood in Our Wells. Of course, I'm very against their ideas. Also another Nazi sympathized band, unfortunately, but their music is very special. Caladan Brood from United States of America, and one and the only one and the one album of them, Echoes of Battle. Atmospheric black, epic black metal with Tolkien influences. They are continuing the way of Summoning. Very, very special band and album. Dimmu Borgir from Norway. And for me, their best album of all time, Enthroned Darkness Triumphant. A really good, majestic black metal band and album. Satanic Warmaster, another guy, one-man's band from Finland, also Nazi sympathizer, unfortunately. And his second or third album, I'm not sure, Opfelblot, something like that. Emperor in the Night Side Eclipse, their debut album of Emperor, also a great majestic black metal album. Bathory, and their album Blood, Fire, Death. Ancient Rites from Belgium. They played the style between thrash, black metal, epic metal, something between all of these, and their second album, Blasphemia Eternal. Ancient Rites. Also, there are some people, they say that they are Nazi sympathizers. A very special also band. I am from Greece originally, so Rotting Christ, of course. Their third album, Triarchy of the Last Lovers. Mugla, I prefer it, I'm not sure, from Poland. Also, they are a little bit Nazi sympathizers. Fortunately, Exercises in Futility. This is a great, great, great album. Their third album. Something very, very, very special. Another great band from Norway. Hades. Hades, Hades, Hades Almighty. Afterwards, they became Hades Almighty. The Dawn of the Dying Sun. A very, very good album of epic black metal. Behemoth from Poland. And their second album, Grom. In these years, they played really black metal. Dawn from Sweden. Also another important band of melodic black with death metal influences in their music. And their last second full studio album, Slaughter Sun, Crown of the Triarchy. Maybe they will make another new album in the period that will come, but this was a masterpiece. Isengard, one of the bands of Fenris. He plays here something between folk, Norwegian metal, black metal, between all of these. This is his second album, Hostmørket, something like that. If I'm speaking about Isengard, I have also to speak about another great band with only one album, Storm. Here we are in Storm, and here also Fenris from Dark Throne, Satyr from Satyricon, also in this great album. Also something between folk, Norwegian metal, and black metal. And the name of the album was Nordavind. Dark Throne, of course. And Transylvanian Hunger. For me, this is the best true Norwegian black metal, lo-fi. Also, I could also speak here about A Blaze in the Northern Sky, but I prefer here to put this masterpiece. Summoning from Austria, the best atmospheric Tolkien black metal band, and their masterpiece Minas Morgul. Thorns, and his only album until now by the name Thorns, a very good industrial black metal, let's say intelligent black metal, call it how you want. Dissection, of course, from Sweden, another great melodic black metal with some death metal influences. Storm of the Lights, Bane, their second album of them, of course. Carpathian Forest from Norway, Morbid Fascination of Death. Here, this is the third album of them, I'm not sure. And this is a very special album with punk influences, with jazz influences in their music, but they are great, great, great. Another great Swedish melodic black with death metal influences band, Viterland, and their only album, Welcome My Last Chapter. Another Norwegian band, Trelldom. This band was the band of Gaal, and their album Till Mine, something like that. Dark Funeral, and their second studio album, yes, Vobiscum Satanas. I like this album so much. Abigor from Austria, and their album Nachtigmen from the Twilight Kingdom. Tormentor from Hungary, of course, Anno Domini. Bethlehem from Germany, one of the best suicidal depressive black metal bands with doom also metal influences in their music, and their third album Suicidis, something like that. Spectral Wound from Canada, Quebec of Canada, I'm not sure, and their second album Infernal Decadence. Satyricon and their first debut album Dark Medieval Times. Vatain from Sweden and their fourth album Lawless Darkness. Judas Iscariot and their and his fifth last album of him To Embrace the Corpses Bleeding. Gradle of Filth from England, of course, and their fifth album Cruelty and the Beast. Another now band from Greece, Necromandia, and this is their second album, Scarred Evil Waiting Black. Marduk from Sweden, and this is their fourth album by the name Heaven Shall Burn When We Are Gathered, a very, very great also album. One Man's Child from Norway, and his second album, The Pagan Prosperity. And last but not least, another Swedish melodic black with death metal influences band and album, Lord Belial, and their album, their second album, Enter the Moonlight Gate. These were the 50 best black metal, top black metal albums of all time, from Israel, from Jerusalem, Stay Metal and Stay Heavy.